What's going on, guys? Antrod here, and welcome back to yet another episode of Antrod Reacts. Today, we're going to be continuing our journey with the NF album, Hope. Oof, shit. Last week, we checked out the song, Careful, which was an amazing piece. Super fun, super enjoyable, and really just introduced more of this album and introduced more of the message behind it, and it was great. But this week, we touch on a tough subject. Many years ago, to those of you who don't know, NF released a song called How Could You Leave Us, which was all about his mother. In this album, he released a song called Mama. And we can only guess it's going to be a heavy hitter, and I'm going to probably cry. So, grab your tissues, grab some popcorn, get ready for some emotional entertainment as we delve into the song Mama. But before we get into that, we have one last little quick tidbit to get into. Editor, cue the music. Yo, I got the stuff that's gonna blow your mind. Keep your hair in line. Just check out mine. I got an oil baseball made, medium hold with high shine. It's easy to apply.
And it smells divine.
You heard that guy. I was jumping the sharp note to divert your eyes. You got shampoo, conditioner, or bars of soap. Even after all that, you're still not broke. They got all these products for a reasonable price. Social shaving, cream and aftershave, pomades from every fade. Apple from every day.
Never mention the name.
Oh. Go check out Suavecito! So get yourself some Suavecito today. The affiliate link provided in the description below and use my discount code. All can be found in the description below. Look good, smell good, and feel good using only one product. Now that that's over with, we are going to get into this reaction, but I have one last personal message to say. Thank you. Thank you so much for checking out these videos. Thank you so much for checking out these reactions and subscribing and liking and checking out the music and the channel and everything. Thank you so much for what you guys do. I very much appreciate everything that you guys do. My goal this year was to hit 2,000 subscribers, and I'm currently almost there to 1,700. I'm definitely going to reach my goal for the year, and it's because of you guys. So just thank you for everything that you guys do. I can't say that enough. Anyways, thank you so much for being here. Let's get into this reaction. Not going to hold you guys up anymore. NF, Mama, let's go.
Hey, ooh. Oh, wow. Ooh. Hey, ooh. Oh, wow.
Yeah, you ever make it?
I'm sorry, I know I'm pausing only 22 seconds in. I want to reverse that later on and see what that says. So in editing, I'm going to reverse it. Editor, what does it say anything? If it doesn't, just call me an idiot.
You idiot!
All right, cool. Anyway, let's go ahead and rewind a couple seconds. Let's get right into this. He's jumping right in. Let's get into it.
Yeah. You ever make it up to the gate? And if you did, I wonder, is it a beautiful place? Did he put his arms around you, make you feel like you're safe? Did he grab you by the hand and say that things are okay? I gotta know, mama.
Oh no, holy shit, yeah. Oh my god. This is after. Oof. Oh no. I gotta know, did you ever get to the gate? Did you ever see him? Did he rap? He's talking about, to those of you, I mean, it's pretty obvious, but in case it's not to some people, he's talking about, did she ever make it to Heaven's Gate and see God? God. Okay.
Place. Did he put his arms around you, make you feel like you're safe? Did he grab you by the hand and say that things are okay? I gotta know, mama. Did he show you some grace, give you a passing, tell you he would carry the weight? Do you smile more? Wonder what it's like when you pray? Is he standing in the...
What is that in the background? I'm sorry. I'm hearing...
I wonder, is it a beautiful place? Did he put his arms around you, make you feel like you're safe? Did he grab you by the hand and say that things are okay? I gotta know.
There's some kind of whispering in the back of the headphones that's traveling. I can't tell what it's saying, but there's definitely a whispering jumping between the headphones. That's very chilling. Feels like you have kind of something listening in almost. To me, it strikes me as a very unique type of way of creating it, because I'm sure as he was making this song, he felt...
I can't say for anybody, but I imagine he probably like felt a presence while he was making this song, you know, or, you know, felt his mom watching him as he made this, or feels his mom watching him throughout the times that he's making music, you know. And so it almost gives me like this chilling feeling in the headphones that something else is listening with me. You know what I mean? Like, I get that vibe. I'm probably overthinking it, which I always overthink things, but that's the vibe I get, that there's whispering in the background, like, listening in. It's so interesting how you threw that in there. It's a unique way to fill the room. All right, I am so sorry. Keep up. Let's keep going.
Yeah.
You ever no more pausing to the gate, and if for you a few did, minutes.
I wonder, is it a beautiful place? Did he put his arms around you, make you feel like you're safe? Did he grab you by the hand and say that things are okay? I gotta know, mama. Did he show you some grace, give you a passion, tell you he would carry the weight? Do you smile more, wonder what it's like when you pray? Is he standing in front of you so you can look at his face when you talk to him? Does he talk back? You ever have conversations about what you regret? Or did it all go away once you got there? Does each breath take you?
Oh my God, do you ever talk about what you regret? Or did it all go away once you got there? I never thought about that question. Wow. This has got me thinking about my mom, man. This hurts. Keep going.
You closer to God, would you say that you cry less? Do you feel at peace yet? Do you laugh more? You feel like heaven is everything you could ask for. I ever make it up there when I see you, I hope you're smiling because you deserve it. Pray to God that you found joy and always know that. You don't gotta cry. You don't gotta cry no more. I hope you're up there looking down on us with a smile on your face. You don't gotta cry. You don't gotta cry no more. I hope you're up there with God, feeling loved and set free from your pain. Hey, I look at the situation you had. Might have made a mistake of leaving, but it's making me sad thinking of you.
Wow. Oh, wow. This is making me think about my mom, dude. This said it last week in one of the reactions, but my mom is everything to me, man. My mom's still here, by the way. Like, I don't want you to think that, you know, my mom's not with us, but, like, I love my mom. You know, my mom is everything to me, you know? Sometimes when I'm, like, at my lowest, you know, I'll pick up the phone and I'll call her. It helps me get through the day, you know? It's just a very powerful piece, you know? And I just love how he says, you know, when you get up there, you know, I hope you have a smile on your face because you deserve it. This is a heavy hitter for sure, and we still have another couple of minutes to go, so let's keep going.
Yo, how you grew up trying to cope with your past? Were you like me in your relationships and pushed away dad? I gotta know, mama. Did you think you were trash? Something disposable that nobody could love or be glad to say they was with you? That issue is the issue I have. That's why it hurt me when Brittany gave me those letters you sent. I barely read any of them, knowing I'd let them go to my head and get to me, especially when I feel I related. Might not be around for my babies, but know when I say that I love you, that I mean it, okay? Cause nobody's perfect. Yeah, I guess we all fall short, and I can't hold this unforgiveness in my heart no more. So just know you're lovable to me, and of course you'll always be mama to us. So save a table for four and know that.
Holy crap. Always set a table for four. Even if she's not there, always set a table for, always set a spot for her. And she taught he wow. Alright, keep going. I'm struggling with this one, guys.
You don't gotta cry. You don't gotta cry no more. I hope you're up there looking down on us with a smile on your face. You don't gotta cry. You don't gotta cry no more. I hope you're up there with God, feeling loved and set free from your pain.
Oh, wow.
You don't gotta cry.
I love that. I was like, that sounds so cool. It's mama. Auto-tuned and pitched up to make it sound like an instrumental almost. That's so cool. I'm sorry. I just punched me because I heard it. And it was, Mama. I was like, oh, shit. Oh, that's what that said. Cool. Very cool. Keep going.
Cry. No.
Yeah, I'm grown now. Took me a while to see the bigger picture. Cause if you were here today and I was talking with you, there'd be a lot of tears of joy falling on my sweatshirt. Probably followed by some apologies and mom, I missed you. Yeah, I pray you see me down here looking up. Still got a lot of things that I need healing from.
Yeah.
But I'll get there eventually, so don't you worry none. I just hope you finally got some peace and you feel happy, mom. I love you.
It's about time. It's about time. It's about time, man. Back when he wrote, How Could You Leave Us, he kept saying, I don't think I could ever forgive you. You know? And all this stuff. A lot of hatred and anger toward his mom. You know? He's grown up so much. You know? Like, he went from, I'll never forgive you, hatred toward his mom, to, Mom, I love you, and I apologize for everything. It's about time that we kind of got the second half of How Could You Leave Us. Like, it's not saying it's about time, you know, but, like, his growth as a person is reflected in these songs. You know, we've seen him grow as a person more so as a creator throughout these albums. And I said when I heard Hope, the song Hope, I said that this album might either be the end of a chapter, the end of the series, basically, or the start of a new series, because it seems like this album is building into a form of a finale, if that makes sense. You know what I mean? To me, Hope, the first song, Hope, was the thesis and the foundation for this album. And I feel like it was the introduction to the finale. Does that make sense? I don't think he's going to quit music after the album is done, after this album, you know what I mean? It wouldn't surprise me, but it definitely feels like this is coming up to a conclusion, almost. And what he's going to be talking about next is going to be so different for us after we're done listening to this. You know what I mean? Like, there's so much he could write from this. There's so much. There's the journey of parenthood, of growth. I mean, we've seen him grow so much as a person, but now he has to grow as something else now, as a father. And there's so much you could write about when it comes to that, and having to deal with his mental baggage on top of trying to be a good dad. You know what I mean? Just hearing this song gives me that feeling of he's finally tied off a loose end that we have been waiting to hear or never expected to hear. And now that we have, it's like, damn, like, how long did it take him to finally say what he said in this song? This was a loose end that he tied off, for sure. And I feel like a lot of what he's talking about in this album so far is really tying up a lot of loose ends, and it's making me wonder, is he going to retire after this, or is he going to start new? Not that he's reached the peak in his music career, but he's reached a point in his personal journey where I wonder how he's going to continue it. See what I mean? I'm not talking bad about NF at all. I don't want anyone to think that. I don't want him to quit making music. I'm not bored of the message he's been delivering. I'm not bored of the journey. I'm not trying to talk bad. I'm simply saying it would not surprise me if he retired after this album, because he's at a critical point in his growth, it seems. So he could potentially retire after this, or, I mean, obviously, there's so much more to learn as far as the growth into fatherhood. And I mean, even NF himself has said, you know, there's a lot of stuff in my head that I have yet to deliver. He said that in the Clouds mixtape. You know, it's definitely exciting to see where he could go after this if he doesn't retire. You know what I mean? Not that I want him to, just it's a very curious thought. And this one, this song itself was just amazing. It wasn't How Could You Leave Us? I mean, he even said himself said nothing could top that song. You know what I mean? But it was definitely impactful. And just like How Could You Leave Us, I was more crying about my own mom. You know what I mean? And as well as hearing his message through about his mom, it made me think about my mom and family members that I might lose, you know? Great piece. Great song. I cannot wait to see what else we got in this album. We've got 8 more songs in this album, and the next one that should be coming out next week is called Pandemonium, and I'm really excited to see what we have with that one. But now, thank you so much, like, so much for being here, checking out this video, seeing this reaction, hearing me blabber on. I hope you guys enjoy my reaction as well as this video. If this is your first time checking out NF, I highly recommend you check out more of his music. He's an amazing creator, an amazing artist, and he's just great. And I highly recommend him. Be aware, if you're going to listen to his music, bring some tissues, because his music is very impactful for the mental battles and all that kind of stuff. It's like, bring some tissues if you're going to check out some of his music. Check him out in the description below. Give him some love. Follow him. All the good happy stuff. This is your first time checking me out as a content creator and a reactor. Usually I'm much more hype and more energy, but this one was one I knew I needed to like calm down and really focus in, because this was not going to be a high energy song, and I was right. But I do have a lot more high energy music and a lot more reactions here on the channel. You can check out some by NF, some by other artists, so on and so forth. So check out the channel where I react to music as well as make music. I just released a couple of songs recently. Memories, Prefer to Be Alone. There's a bunch of them. Check out the channel where I have music. There's a whole playlist of my original songs I've created throughout the years. My good stuff, my bad stuff, so on and so forth. So like, share, subscribe, all the good happy stuff. Thank you so much for being here. And without further ado, and right out.